Hello, language learners! How are you doing? Learning something new all the time, right? I'm so proud of you, good job! And I'm here today to tell you about differences in grammatical genders in languages. In our case, in Russian, English and German. Our life shows that those can be quite tricky and misleading. But now, let's get started! As some of you have heard in my previous videos, I am a Russian girl married to a German guy, and the language of our relationship is English, though we also try to learn each other's languages. And early on we noticed some interesting facts about genders in Russian, German and English. First of all, in German there are three genders: feminine, masculine and neutral, and each of them goes with its own article. For example, feminine, die Karte. Masculine, der Stift, and neutral, das Kissen. And those were, by the way, the definite article. They also have indefinite articles, and all of them are changed when you change the case, and that's a pain in the ass, to be honest, for the learner, but that's not the point here. In Russian there are also three genders: masculine, feminine and neutral, and sometimes you can guess which gender is this noun because of the ending of the noun. But it does not work all the time, and many times you just need to know the gender or learn the gender or guess the gender to use the word correctly. And that's also not really nice for learners, right? To give you an example, we'll look at the same words as we looked at in German. So the map is she in Russian, we would refer to it as she. The pen, we'll refer to it as she. And our pillow is also she. And the fact they are all feminine is just a pure coincidence. More or less we have an equal amount of words in all the genders. And in modern English, as you probably know, there is no strict distinction between feminine and masculine gender for most of the objects around us. I mean, when we are talking about this pen, we would refer to a pen as it. The same for the map and the pillow. Though genders are many times shown when we are talking about people and professions. To give you an example, boy, girl, it's masculine and feminine. The same with actor, actress, prince, princess, and many other words. And now, keeping that in mind, I will give you an example from our own experience of gender confusion that can happen when a Russian-speaking person and a German-speaking person are talking English. And now let's imagine our talk, let's say, about wedding rings. We had quite some talks about them, so I think it's a good example. I'm also talking via WhatsApp. Hey, how did you like the ring that I sent you? I think this is a nice one.
Yeah, he looks great.
He? Who is he?
The wedding ring, for sure.
Oh, it's masculine in German, der Ring. In Russian, it's neutral. We say кольцо, and it's neutral. Oh, the walk around the city, and let's say I would see a bridge and say, oh, look at this bridge, it looks so nice, let's cross him. And my husband will be like, him? Let me guess, it's masculine in Russian, right? And I would be like, oh yeah, sorry, we say most, and it's masculine in Russian. I should admit, because of this strange confusion, I've learned quite some genders in German. It just was a funny situation and it made me remember genders. I guess the same for my husband. And I should admit, we made a lot of mistakes like this. Though we are speaking quite good English, just the concept of grammatical genders is so strong in our mind that it influenced us a lot. And because of that, I started to think, is it influencing us somehow? I mean, is this something more than just some mistakes and misunderstanding? Maybe it shapes our mind and our word perception somehow? And then I started to read about it and I watched some videos and I found out that this is a really interesting topic and I want to share some things that I've learned with you. Scientists have learned that the answers to those questions are complicated. And they are complicated because not only language but also culture and many other factors are involved. However, recent researchers have revealed that when we are learning our mother tongue, we acquire certain habits of thought and they shape our perception and our experience in many ways. And then I saw a TED Talk video where Lena Boroditsky was sharing her experiments and her thoughts on languages and how they shape our reality. She tells about many different ways in which languages influence our life. If you want to watch it, I will put a link here. And considering genders, she described one experiment that I really like. They asked German-speaking people and Spanish-speaking people to describe a word. So that was the word bridge. And German-speaking people were describing it as beautiful, elegant. And the Spanish-speaking people were describing it mostly as strong and long. The thing is, the difference between those descriptions mostly was determined by the grammatical gender, at least this is what they think. Because for German-speaking people, the bridge is feminine, so the characteristics were also kind of feminine, more feminine. And for Spanish-speaking people, el puente, the word is masculine, so they were describing it with a more masculine kind of adjectives. That means that for me and my husband, it's probably not only some mistakes. Maybe we are looking at some objects a bit differently and we refer to them differently and describe them tiny bit differently. And I haven't looked into it and actually I haven't noticed such things before. But I think it will be quite interesting if I notice them in future. This experiment partly proves that languages shape our perception in some kind of way. But how big is really the influence? This question is still far from being answered. It all may sound a bit complicated, but it just means that learning another language is a chance to get some insight into another culture, another way of life, another way of thinking. And this is another reason to keep learning a foreign language or to learn a new one, right? And if you're interested in learning languages and getting to know more about them, subscribe to my channel, watch my new videos, and I will be happy to see you here again. Bye!